2 months ago, Chris Taylor had never fought in a professional wrestling match. Even so, while still in training, he signed the highest contract in the history of pro wrestling, $400,000 over the next 5 years. Considering his 450 pounds, that's about $55 an ounce, which makes him worth nearly half his weight in gold. What makes Chris Taylor worth so much, aside from his size, is his record as an amateur. He won the Big Eight title twice. He was national collegiate champion in 72 and 73. And he was a bronze medal winner in the 72 Olympics. In his 2 years at Iowa State, he won 87 matches without a loss, 70 of them by pins. Small wonder, then, that pro wrestling promoters are smacking their lips with anticipation. But it's a long way from an amateur match like this to this. This is professional wrestling at its finest, so to speak. Fighting in a main event like this one, with some of the biggest names and biceps in the business, is the goal of practically every pro wrestler. But more than half the battle is getting there. For Chris Taylor, it began last October at world champion Verne Gagne's wrestling farm near Chanhazen. About 20 hopefuls showed up during the first 2 weeks of training. Most of them couldn't take the calisthenics and dropped out.
50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 20.
Hop, down, hop, down, 235. Good, Chris.
Very good. That belly's coming out about 3 inches already.
Very good.
The one thing about wrestling that makes it colorful, it's made up of many different individuals. And this is an individual sport, a free enterprise. You can do your own thing, you can be your own self. It's no different than pro football or pro basketball or pro hockey or anything else. It has to be colorful, it has to be exciting.
It's not like amateur wrestling. You have to do not worry about the point system, because there isn't any point system. Now, if a man is going to take you over and you're going to hurt yourself, he's going to try and bring you over and throw you over, then it's better to go with it and land your own way so you don't get hurt as bad.
Assisting Verne Gagne is Billy Robinson, who is himself one of pro wrestling's top performers.
Well, I've been fortunate enough to help coach many members of Olympic teams in collegiate wrestling and a few good professional wrestlers. And I believe that Chris could be as good as any professional wrestler there's ever been.
Don't put him down. Stay in your feet. Stay in your feet. Dive over the arm. Dive over. Watch. Real simple. Chris, now get up and dive over it. Good. Good. Remember, falling is basic. You got to know how to fall. If you don't know how to fall, you're going to get hurt. And if you're hurt, you can't wrestle. And if you can't wrestle, you don't eat. It's that simple.
2.5 months of training with Verne Gagne is not easy. It was without a doubt the hardest training I've ever been through in my life. I mean, I've wrestled on the Olympic teams and a world team, and I've never been through a workout like that. I wish that I could have done it before the Olympics.
Come on, the guys, get back in the ring. Come on, come on, dig, 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 dig. Dig, dig, dig.
That's one thing that I've never been much at doing is running. You know, Chris, and I feel like just saying, forget it, you know, I'm all done. But there's something, I don't know, something in every athlete that I think that if you don't give 100%, when you go home at night, you don't feel right about it.
Okay, Chris, hip lock off the ropes. Okay, grab again, fly mare.
It's December 3rd in the Minneapolis Armory. Chris Taylor's professional debut is just 5 days away.
Slam! Right, there he is! Okay, boom. Okay, cover him. All All right, okay.
Now, your pain tolerance has been built up on all you guys. I mean, you can take the slams better now than you could. You can take a flying mare better. The shock, you're learning how to fall. And the shock is going through your system. It's still the same shock you had the first time someone threw you down. But you're building up a tolerance to it.
Chris, you better get over there in those.
Yeah. Chris, remember, once you felt yourself going again, I was freaking hurt yourself. You plowed it on your shoulder. Remember, if you're that far gone, get your body over so you land that flat way again. We don't want, man, that's how you, that guy will not survive long if you don't learn to get over. Okay. You laid on him now.
Oh, no.
All right, now, the referee can hear that. There's 10,000 people out here screaming. You want to quit before your arm is broke. You better make some noise, brother. Okay, put it on him.
Go ahead, Chris.
Okay. Now, hang on to it once. I'll be the referee. All right, but break before five, you'll be disqualified.
Yeah.
Ready? Okay, got a minute. All right, break. Break, Chris. One, two, three. All right, you got five counts, so a lot of these guys will hold you till right at the last second before they let you go. So by five counts, I'm telling you, you're pretty groggy. There. All right, Bob, you're back, right? Did you land it pretty flat, right? Okay. Pick up Chris. Just go in there and see if you can do it.
Come on, Bob.
There you go. Okay, next, crouch. Okay.
Get under him.
Okay. All right, well, we know you can't lift him. Okay, let me try
next.
I'll just run. No, shit. No. Okay, here. Oh. No way. He's gonna get you up. There aren't many guys. The Giant might be able to pick him up, right?
Right.
Donnelly or Jonathan might be able to pick him up.
Yeah.
Maybe if you ever wrestle against material, which I doubt for quite some time. He might be able to pick you up, but men like that. But I know I, at 230 pounds, I can't pick you up. But it's a good question. How does it feel to be up there? I wouldn't worry about that too much, but there will be the time. It was a good question. What I do if I ever get up there?
Great.
Panic. Now, I might be choking him.
Come on, what's going on?
All the while, comes around to see it. The people will see him doing it. They'll be screaming at the referee. But again, he can only call what he sees. So don't depend on the referee to break that hold. And the guy's dragging you around. Get out of it yourself. Fight out of it. So don't just walk out there, pick him up and lay him down. We want to see some action. We want to see what you can do.
Run into him. Hey,
headlock. Lock him. Good. Go. Jack, come on.
Move, folks.
Come on up. Nope. There we go. Okay, great. Okay. All right, any questions right now? Are they fresh in your mind?
I think 3-4 more days like this and I'll be ready to go.
Okay, fine. All right, you've got to be ready to go because Saturday's the date. You'll be ready. Okay. All right, that's it.
I was thinking, just what in the world am I going to do or what am I doing here, Just the idea that I had to go out against somebody that I've never seen wrestle before. I didn't know what in the world to do. I was worried. I my mind was blank.
The more I talk, the more nervous he gets. So.
Okay, good luck, Christopher.
If you can do it,
you'll do it.
Good luck, Chris.
If you walk out and they boo you, you know, you're the bad guy at the time. That's it. I felt like they were behind me 100%. I mean, when they announced my name and that, everybody cheered it. It was really great, you know. But it's something that it could have went either way. It really could have. And I was very happy it went the right way.
Here he is.
The matches are not made, and the style is not dictated to by the wrestlers. It's what will the fans go and see. So the matchmaker has to be smart enough to match the proper guys together to catch the people's imagination.
One thing I noticed that whenever I do something aggressive where you pick a guy up, hold him up here, and then throw him down, the crowd would explode a bit. And this is something that really makes you feel good. You know, they're really for me. You know, you go out there and you do it again. You try to do things to please them. This is what it's all about. And this is what I try to do. Well, until you get into it, until you get involved and start getting thrown around and really being there where the punches are coming at you and where the blood's flying, if it happens to be, and things like that, you really don't realize. It's really a lot tougher than I thought it was. I mean, as a matter of fact, it's brutal. People love violence to a point. They love it rugged. In America especially, they want action. They want their money's worth. I would rather wrestle, prefer a clean bout all the time, but it won't draw money. So I have to wrestle guys like Rashawn, Nick Bockwin, Lee Stevens, Superstar. That's what draws big money. And this is the reason why you have different personalities in wrestling. Mistakes. He's going to be inhibited. A year from today, you'll see an entirely different Chris Taylor. And 3 years from today, it'll be a whole different ball game. He'll be a professional. He'll be a real seasoned pro.